In this illustration, we'll discuss about multiple isotopes in a radioactive sample. Here we are given that a sample of uranium is a mixture of isotopes 234, 235 and 238 present in ratios of these values. And always remember, whenever such ratios are given, these are always the mass ratios in a mixture. Half-lives of these isotopes are also given here. We are required to calculate the contribution to activity of each isotope in the sample. So, in solution here, you can see first we can write down the decay constant of each isotope. So, here we can write decay constant of decay constants of isotopes are, these are given as lambda 1 as 0.693 by first half life is 2.5 into 10 to power 5 per year. For the second isotope, it is 0.693 by 7.1 into 10 to power 8 year inverse. And that of third isotope is 0.693 by 4.5 into 10 to power 9 per year. And if we are having the decay constant, we can directly write down the activity of each isotope in a sample of mass M is, for a sample of mass M here, we can write activity of first isotope will be lambda 1 N1. Lambda 1 we can write as 0.693 by 2.5 into 10 to power 5 multiplied by number of atoms. We can calculate by using the mole formula, which can be given as, for first isotope, the percentage of mass is 0.006 by 100 times mass multiplied by Avogadro number divided by mass number, that is 234. Similarly, for the second isotope, it is lambda 2 N2, that can be given as lambda 0.693 by 7.1 into 10 to power 8 multiplied by its mass ratio is 0.71 by 100 times M multiplied by Avogadro number by 235. And for the activity of third isotope, it is lambda 3 N3, that is 0.693 by 4.5 into 10 to power 9 multiplied by its mass's maximum, which is 99.284 divided by 100 times M multiplied by Avogadro number by 238. From these numerical values, if we take the ratios here, we can see activity 1 is to activity 2 is to activity 3. Their ratio is given by 0.01026 is to 0.000426 is to 0.00927. So, these are the activity ratios for these three values for a common factor. If we are having the activity ratios, we can directly calculate the percentage activity contribution of each isotope, as total activity will be given by the sum of the three activities. So, here we can write percentage activity of first isotope is activity 1 upon activity 1 plus activity 2 plus activity 3 multiplied by 100. If you substitute these numerical values with a constant factor, this comes out to be 51.41%. Similarly, percentage contribution of activity 2, we can give as activity 2 divided by AC1 plus AC2 plus AC3 multiplied by 100, and it comes out to be 2.13%. And in the similar manner, we can calculate the percentage contribution of third isotope in activity, that is activity 3 upon AC1 plus AC2 plus AC3 multiplied by 100. And on numerically calculating the values, this gives us 46.45%. So, these are the final results of the percentage contributions of activity for the 3 isotopes in the sample.